स्टूडेंट, आई होप यू ऑल आर फाइन। ओके, दिस इज योर वीक फिफ्थ असाइनमेंट, योर क्लास सिक्स्थ एंड सब्जेक्ट साइंस। टुडेज लेक्चर इज बेस्ड अपॉन मोर एविडेंस दैट पार्टिकल्स आर ऑलवेज मूविंग। मोर एविडेंस मीन्स दैट मोर प्रूफ दैट पार्टिकल्स आर ऑलवेज मूविंग। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, आफ्टर लिसनिंग द लेक्चर वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स। Student will be able to explain the concept that particles are always moving, explain the concept of amorphous solid, also perform activity work. Evidence for the spaces between molecules. Liquid molecule have spaces between them. Liquid molecules have spaces between them means that water or honey, this is the liquid, so their molecules have spaces between them. When the alcohol and water are mixed, water molecule fit into some of the spaces between the alcohol molecules. Alcohol is a chemical which is also used in the lab or chemistry labs. When the alcohol and water, when both these liquid, alcohol liquid and water liquid are mixed, these molecules are fit into some of the space between the alcohol molecules. This then makes the volume smaller than you would accept. Activity work. Okay, this activity is very important and you will perform this activity on your home after listening the lecture. You can model this for yourself by mixing 50 centimeter cube of rice. You take 50 centimeter cube of rice and 50 centimeter cube of peas. Shake the two together and look at the final volume of a mixture. You can take 50 centimeter cube of rice and then 50 centimeter cube of peas. You can mix it together and shake well, then you will take the final volume of a mixture. This activity is very interesting. You will strictly perform this activity on your Did you know information? Some solids such as glass and plastic do not have a crystalline structure. These are called amorphous solid. Amorphous solid mean all those material which do not have a sharp edges. These are called amorphous solid. Do not have a crystalline structure. Crystalline structure mean sharp structure like this glass and rubber. These are called amorphous solid because they do not have a crystalline or sharp edges. So these are called amorphous solid. Okay, your today's homework is test yourself on page number 36, question 1, 3, 5 and 7. Only these questions you will write on your notebook.